Today is half Christmas. I'm fucking excited. I'm feeling the Christmas cheer.
I'm ecstatic.
I'm hearing the Christmas cheer.
You know Christmas is my favorite time of year.
Uh-huh. The best time.
Getting celebrated twice.
Getting celebrated
twice is nice.
More than twice, because there's also quarter Christmas. And there's three-quarter Christmas.
Shit, that's right.
And you could break it up into fractions, smaller and smaller, all the way until you're celebrating Christmas every day. But we're not going to do that.
Yeah, I got the 12 months of Christmas. That's what I got.
The 12 months of Christmas.
Yeah, that's my shit.
That's not bad. It's like an extended Judaism where you just get presents forever.
Yep.
I like it. We might start rocking that after this. But for now, we're just going to do half Christmas. Because a lot of people out there hate Christmas. Can you believe that?
And this one's for them. Fuck you guys.
The Natural Habitat Podcast. The Natural Habitat Podcast.
Yo, the Natural Habitat Podcast Half Christmas Special is in full effect.
What?
Mm-hmm, that's how you know, because of the horn. It's only special occasions when I remember to pull that up.
Holy shit, Jay.
Welcome to the show, everybody. My name is Mikey Booyah.
My name is Nick Saint.
That's just a hype name, so I gotta hype it up every time. You know what
Nick
I mean?
Nick Saint.
So myself and Nick Saint here are just here to celebrate the half Christmas season. We were sitting down in the theater and we were like, "What movie are we gonna watch today?" We're flipping through all these laser discs that we have, which is all that they give us for movies, but we have everything on laser disc, and we realized that today is half Christmas, and. Yeah. I literally jumped out of my seat, onto my seat, in the middle of the movie theater. I pulled out a gun and I was like, "Nobody move!" And I was like, "Today's half Christmas. We can't watch movies. We gotta celebrate." And then I left without hurting anybody.
Yeah, you know, everything's been going so good. We've been kicking so much ass, having so many good episodes.
It's actually
like lost track of time, and
it's actually pronounced arse.
Arse, yeah.
Yeah, because we're now a German podcast. Our sponsors are German.
Oh, yeah.
And now now we pronounce it arse.
I'm Meister Arse Kissa.
So we've been doing such a great job that we decided we would take a day off from the commentaries, from the movie reviews, from all of these cinema-related things that we do on Saturday, and we would spend some time celebrating half Christmas. One of my favorite holidays ever.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's not a normal thing. I think people overlook it a little bit. And I think, like, you know, by the time June comes around, everybody's summer focused. You know, everybody's like, "Oh, got to hit the beach. Got to get a tan. Got to be out in the sun. Got to do all kinds of summer shit."
Yeah.
And everybody forgets all about Christmas, you know. And this is a perfect reminder. Well, it's never too early to start planning ahead, you know what I mean? Maybe if some people use the half Christmas as the mark to like start their Christmas shopping early, 6 months from then, when Christmas actually gets there, they got all their shit done, they're not stressing out, it's not a fucking fight to like worry about what you gotta get, you're all prepared, you know what I'm saying? You're ready to go, and then it's like just like a chill time and you just get to soak it all up and enjoy the fucking holiday, you know?
Yeah, enjoy the family, enjoy the feelings of love and warmth that are in the holidays instead of trying to run around like Arnold Schwarzenegger trying to fight over the last fucking Wonder Man doll or whatever the fuck it is. But there's a reference in there somewhere.
Yeah, fuck, I wish we knew the name right now.
It's from Jingle All the Way.
Yeah,
and
the doll is named, and
it's not a doll; it's an action figure.
Cause it's Captain Insano.
I remember they were always yelling at each other. That's pretty close.
Like that.
I'm gonna look, I'm just going to count down from three, and then I'm going to know the answer instantly in my head because, you know, it's just, it's going to be magical stoner work. So three, all right. Two, one.
Turbo Man, doll.
Ah, shit.
Turbo Man. That's it.
Turbo Man.
Turbo Man, doll.
Turbo Man, get to the chopper.
Give me the Turbo Man. Look, I'm Turbo Man, son.
At the end of the movie, he became Turbo Man.
I know, he rocked that shit too.
Fuck yeah, and then he was like,
drum set.
Give me your hand. I'm Turbo Man. Turbo Man talks like your dad.
It's like, don't you think that you would know from the voice? Yeah. Like, hey, that's my dad. He has that weird voice.
He's not a voice actor.
But nobody ever talks about Arnold Schwarzenegger's voice. And I brought that up before.
Nobody talks about Arnold Schwarzenegger to his face.
Nobody talks about Arnold Schwarzenegger at all. Behind his
even
back
as,
or to his
even
face.
As an old man, he'll probably fuck you up.
He's a governor now. He's not even an actor anymore.
He's a.
Is he still? Is he still a governor?
No, bro.
No, no, bro. That was a long time ago.
Yeah. We've had like two or three since him.
Well, that shows how much I pay attention.
Holy shit, Jay!
Mm-hmm.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. All right.
So one thing that I did find out is that you know, I was looking up stuff about Half Christmas and. What I found a lot of Christmas in July shit. That's the thing that people like to say. Christmas in July. It's a saying. And I found out that that's from the other side of the planet from where we are and where we record. In the southern hemisphere, they have opposite seasons than us. So winter is in summertime. Summer is in, you know, or winter is in July and summertime is in, you know, January. So it's reversed. And for them to have that Christmas feel of it being cold and the mittens and the scarves and possibly snow, depending on where they live, then they hold Christmas celebrations in July. Now, July 25th is not half Christmas. June 25th is. That's just math.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sixth month, 12th month, 25th. So half Christmas was made popular by the, I want to say by the Workaholics franchise, web series / TV show. They were the first ones that made it huge a few years ago and started the Half Christmas celebrations.
But, were the only ones?
It was probably done before, but when I look it up, a lot of Workaholics stuff comes just because they were the biggest ones. They might not have been the first ones, but they were ones to push it into pop culture. You know what I mean? To make it blow up over the past few years to where, you know, every year on Half Christmas, I made eggnog this morning. I'm wearing an extremely gay Christmas sweater right now. If I could just, so are you, if I could just describe your sweater, it's green, like a forest green with a bunch of sheep heads on it. And that are kind of like sticking out, made out of yarn and lace. And they have candy canes in their mouths and X's for eyes. And then snowflakes and stuff like that. So do you want to tell people about my sweater or you want to make me do it?
Your sweater was more like a dinosaur with a red nose and like little tiny arms.
Uh-huh.
Like more like a T-Rex kind of. Mm-hmm. But it was like made out of hemp. And it was very like heady.
That's right. I got it on right now. It's very heavy, very hard, very rough to the skin. Just like that hemp fabric. I think that
makes you feel closer to Jesus.
I felt some really good hemp fabrics, like things that are made out of hemp. Like there was a backpack that I had that was made out of hemp that was like, you know, it felt really good, really strong, almost like a Dickies type canvas material. And then there was a hemp sweater that I had that felt like it was a fucking hemp wick without any wax on it. And it was just scratchy and it felt like I was wearing like hay, like I was in a fucking bale of hay. And I think they do that on purpose to try to be like, look, we can't make clothes with this. This isn't worth anything. And they make like shit clothes on purpose. To try to make you go like, I guess it's not really that great.
Yeah.
That's just the theory I have. Man trying to bring
it
down.
Yeah, well, it might not make the softest clothes, but it does make the strongest everything else.
True. And,
you know, it makes the strongest everything. It makes it like a fiberglass material stronger than fucking concrete. It's crazy.
Yeah, that's true. So, what is this? You found a...
I found some origins.
Found some Christmas in July shit?
For Christmas in July.
Or is it Christmas in June?
Well, it's July because it was sold as such. It says one origin is from an opera. Some song of children singing when you sing Christmas in July, you rush the season. And it's from 1894. Mm-hmm. So it's about people like just being geeked out on Christmas and just loving the fucking time and like singing about it already in July because it's on their mind already. And you know what I mean? Same as anybody else who really loves Christmas. I think it's really that infectious.
Yeah. And, so I think it caught on earlier as Christmas in July, and just like any other Christmas thing, it just gets pushed further and further, or you know, closer back. And
yeah,
you know, Christmas used to start at the end of November, right after Thanksgiving, or like, you know, maybe a couple weeks before Thanksgiving, there would be Christmas stuff in the stores and there would be lights and decorations and all kinds of shit for sale. And then it got back to like the beginning of November, and then right after Halloween, and then now it's like October 1st is when Christmas shit starts. Yeah. So, and even sooner than that sometimes. So we naturally went back more into the past and are doing it in June. Because...
And I guess there was a Christmas in July movie in the 40s too as well, so... Yeah, there's a lot to it, you know? There's a lot to it, and I really don't think that the July is, like, any different from June 25th, you know what I mean? Like, it's basically July, so I think maybe it's just more of, like, an ironic thing, you know? Like, more of, like, a summer statement with a half-truth or something like that, you know?
Yeah, and then the actual half-Christmas day would be June 25th today.
Exactly.
So,
yeah, so we're going to celebrate.
Yeah, and then it'll be Christmas in July.
Yeah.
and what is the best way for us to celebrate around here? I couldn't think of a way that we celebrate maybe every time on the show and do something that's celebratory.
Let me think. I'm thinking.
You know thinking. What? In all seriousness, though, that does remind me of a new segment that we have on the show. Yeah. We were talking about it on the last episode, episode 200. We're going to have new stuff coming, new segments, new things to look forward to. And one thing that we're going to try to do on every episode is have a small motivational section that, you know, just kind of like gets you fired up, gets you ready to live your fucking life, ready to make some changes, ready to be the best you that you could be. And we are gonna we're gonna get high while we listen to it, just because that helps with motivation. So you feel free to do the same, or just listen to it. All of this will be handpicked by us. It's not just gonna be like, oh, find us some motivational thing, Jerry. Like, this is gonna be something that we listen to and, you know, spark something in us. So we're gonna show it to you guys, you know.
Yeah,
there's a lot of motivational shit. As well, we talk about a lot of negative shit that's out there, but there's also just as much, if not more, positive shit out there, just like this.
Be the hero of your own movie. If your life was a movie, and it started now, forget about whatever financial disasters you've had, personal failures, relationship failures. What would the hero of your life's movie do right now? Do that. Do those things. We define ourselves far too often by our past failures. We look at our past and we say, well, that's me. That's not you. You are this person right now. You're the person who's learned from those failures. And you can choose to be the hero of your own movie right now. Write down your goals. Write down things you want to improve. Write down things you won't tolerate from yourself. Write down things you've done in the past that you never want to see yourself do again. And go forth from here as the hero of your own movie. Build momentum. Build confidence and momentum with each good decision that you make from here on out. You can do it. Anyone can do it. We live in unique times. We live in one of the rarest times in human history, where you can choose almost all the input that comes your way. Whether it's the movies that you watch, the books you read, the podcasts you listen to, you can choose to be inspired. Do that. Do that, and be the hero of your own movie.
Damn right.
I'm feeling motherfucking heroic.
Yep, that was some motivational shit. Thank you to today's motivational speaker, Jerry Seinfeld. We all know that voice and love it.
Yeah.
Jerry Seinfeld, thank you.
He also has the best podcast in the world, Comedians in Cars, Drinking Caffeine.
I thought he was the host of the Joe Rogan Experience. Am I mixing these guys up?
Yeah.
I don't really pay too much attention to other podcasters besides Awesome Ty with the host of Unsolicited Opinions with Awesome Ty.
Yeah.
He's really the only one I listen to besides us.
Anytime you feel like you need an opinion that you didn't ask for, go check it out.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So I think that there's no better time than now to get into an NHP smoke sesh.
Holy shit, yeah.
Uh-huh, we're going to double up. So
back to back. B2B.
We have
this is a fucking, this is a live DJ set coming from DJ Mike Booyah and motherfucking, what's your DJ name?
Oh, yeah, that's right. DJ Mikey Booyah.
Oh, yeah, all right. And we're coming live back to back. Here we go.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go.
Yeah, give it to me. Give it to me. 5 and 10. Listen. Come on now. Once again,
with candy canes and
silver lanes aglow.
There it is.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hopalong boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go.
Thank you, Bing Crosby.
Yeah, I fucking love that guy.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas right now, except for that
it was snowing.
Except for that it's fucking 115 degrees.
Yeah, I definitely wish it was Christmas. That's probably it, you know what I mean? If you think about it, it's because motherfuckers are miserably hot, and they're just like dreaming about Christmas, daydreaming about Christmas, and they're like, man, I wish it was Christmas right now.
Yeah. July. And if you go inside, you crank the AC, and you put up some Christmas decorations, you listen to Christmas music, put on the Yule log maybe, and you know, cook some sort of Christmas-related food, then you'll feel like...
cold.
Yeah, you'll feel cold. Your body temperature actually goes down 15 degrees. Yeah. This is a study that they did for Half Christmas.
Get a kiddie pool and fill it full of ice water and put it in the living room, you know, and then just dip your feet in that motherfucker while you're sitting on the couch watching the movie.
Yeah.
You're going to feel like you got your feet in the snow.
You're going to, just like you got it in the snow.
You know?
It's going to be great.
Great.
Be the shit.
So,
yeah.
Damn.
I got a little conspiracy afoot.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. A little Christmas time conspiracy.
Oh,
if you will.
Shit. Lay it on us. I'm excited.
Because you know that's my thing, right?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, so, I'm thinking about this. I don't know why it just struck me as odd, but I think that every year everybody's decorations you see are a year behind.
Huh. How so?
Because every year the crazy people who go to all the lengths to decorate, they go shopping in January to buy all their shit.
Oh, and they get all the clearance stuff that was brand new.
Yeah, so every ornate thing that you see, every house that overdoes it and just does it real super big, you know? Those ones are all a year behind because they buy their shit so early because it's like cheaper for them and they have to do it that way to be able to afford it, you know? So, I mean, like, motherfuckers don't have the new shit. So it's like every day we're actually, every Christmas, we're actually like a year behind. We're seeing last year's decorations this year.
Yeah, that totally makes sense.
So nobody even realized that. So like we're in this fucking time warp.
So the guy, the guy that has all the decorations, top to bottom, lights and shit on his roof and shit in his lawn.
Yeah.
That's all stuff from last year or years before that's been recycled and put in boxes. Yeah. And then the guy that has one or two things in his yard maybe has the most up to date shit because he bought it brand new this year and put it up.
That's how it works. You know, and it's funny, it's like every year they're like, "Oh, add a new shit." So you know, it's like, "Oh, I gotta have a new show this year," you know, but really it's still last year's show. Even though it's new to you, you know, it's like,
yeah, that's true.
It's a conspiracy. They don't want us to know what's new. You know, they don't want us to see the new decorations because maybe we can't handle it.
Maybe
if we see like the craziest new LED ones ever, like this year's new shit, future shit, and then we just couldn't handle it. It'd be like too big of a jump, you know. It'd be like a fucking over a year gap jump, and you're just like, whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Everyone would just like break down. Your mental capabilities would be gone. Yeah.
And
he would just be crying. Everyone would be crying.
Yeah. So you have to wait until like the fucking parallel universe is like snap again.
You gotta wait until January and then it's not that scary.
Yeah.
Then once January, then all the new tech stuff comes out that at the end of the year and the end of December, beginning of January, all the new shit drops. So then when you see the shit in January, when you buy that year's decorations, they're not as startling and scary because things have been dropping now. So it's good. But they keep them in some sort of beyond section where the normal person can't get to them.
All right. So we're gonna start a petition. And it's going to be for this year to boycott everybody from buying new decorations. This year, everybody has to recycle last year's decorations. Nobody buys new ones until day before Christmas.
Until the day before Christmas.
Yeah, because that's when you'll get like the most updated version.
That's a good idea. And they'll be forced.
And then you'll be caught up, and then you'll just only have like a few hours to decorate before Christmas.
Nice. And then they'll be forced to put out the most up-to-date stuff that last minute because it'll be a scramble to try to get sales.
Yeah, and then you'll see like all of America from space all at like once.
All plug their lights in at the same time?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Hell yeah. It'd be like creating a new little sun.
I like it.
You'd just be like, whoa.
I don't know if we should play God like that.
Yeah. We might just like fry the whole fucking system. Huh.
Yeah, you never know. Everybody just plugs their shit in and then it's gone. And then we're back at like fucking the dark ages.
We fried the whole electrical grid for the country and then we ruined the internet and then fucking everybody hates us.
Everything's just down.
We'd be dead within 3 days.
And they're like, it's that damn podcast that ruined everything.
Yeah.
And destroyed power and the internet.
They did it.
That's the one thing that's keeping us alive is the internet and power.
I know, right?
And we're just going to,
the internet is the only thing keeping humans alive.
Yeah, true.
Without it, I feel like we would have definitely dropped nukes on each other by now.
Yeah, it's what's keeping humans so healthy and, you know, dominating the Earth. Otherwise, there would just be like, you know, 3,000 of us scattered around, all covered in shit.
That'd be better for the Earth.
Yeah, it'd be nice. It'd be nice for the Earth, but not so good for my emails and stuff.
Nah.
I need emails,
It'd be less hassle.
By the way, email us, naturalhabitatpodcast@gmail.com.
Yeah.
So I have a special treat for the listeners, and for you, Joey. This is a family recipe of the Booyah family half Christmas eggnog. Because, like I said, half Christmas was made popular by you know, the workaholics guys, maybe. And it was.
Did we just have a fucking Mandela effect right now?
Yeah. And then now, you know, we're going back. I'm talking Christmas on June 25th, the half Christmas thing, not Christmas in July. And then, you know, it was around forever. And growing up, it was a big thing in my household. We would always break out the Christmas sweaters. And we would make eggnog in June or July. Maybe it was. I don't remember. And this was one of the things that I still do every half Christmas. So if everyone wants to bust out their pots and pans and get ready to make some eggnog, because you can't buy it in the stores right now. That's the worst thing about half Christmas is you can't just go buy some eggnog.
Yeah, it is seasonal.
Mm-hmm. So what you're going to want to do is combine milk, cloves, a half a teaspoon of vanilla, and cinnamon all in a saucepan. And you want to heat it up, medium heat, cook that shit for 5 minutes. All right? A little simmer for 5 minutes. And then in a big bowl, you combine egg yolks, sugar, whisk that together. And then you stir in cannabis CBD tincture, all right? You want to take like the kind of thing that you add to like a drink or... you could get it at your local dispensary for like $60, little vial of it. You want to pour that whole vial in there, pour it all in there, put some water in the vial, swish it around, pour it in there again, get the last bit of it. And then 2 teaspoons of vanilla, a little bit of nutmeg. Stir it all together. Mix what you boiled and mix what you mix in the bowl all into one.
All right.
Put it in the fridge. Let it chill overnight. You're going to want to make this yesterday. Okay. So, right. Yesterday, put this all together, put it in the fridge, let it chill overnight. The next day, you got some great Booyah eggnog, which will leave you heavily medicated. I replaced the rum with the tincture, so it'll get you high as fuck. What the hell is that?
Raise my hand.
Okay, what the hell? What? That is a... what is it?
I'm raising my hand.
I can't see. All I can see is your hands went away from the top of the screen, and I just saw my elbows.
I have a proposal for a name change.
What is it?
I propose you change the name to Egg Noggin.
Egg Noggin?
Yeah, because it's heady.
Yeah, it does give you a really strong head high. So I like it. Egg Noggin.
Egg noggin.
And that is the recipe for egg noggin. You can make your own, and you will not overdose on it. That's one thing that I could safely say. I could tell people to pour that whole, you know, 20 doses into their thing. And yeah, if anything, you're just going to freak out and fall asleep. So
here's the slogan. Egg noggin. You'll live.
Egg noggin. You'll live. I doubt you'll be the first person to overdose.
Yeah. Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah. So go make your eggnoggin at home and let us know how it turned out. You can actually make it the whole month of July or year-round, whenever you want. I guess that like any day that's not Christmas can be considered half Christmas.
Yeah.
You know, it really doesn't matter because a calendar was just, it's all bullshit anyway. So I could just be like, yeah, it's not Christmas, so I'm celebrating Christmas on a not Christmas day. Half Christmas. Doesn't need to make sense. Doesn't need to be halfway. Because who says that I need to stick to your Gregorian ways and celebrate 365 and a quarter days a year?
Yeah.
Not me.
Yeah, I mean, that's my shit, though.
You're all about it.
I like it 365 days a year. That's my shit right there. Every day.
Yeah?
Every day is Christmas,
even,
man.
Even the quarter?
Every day you wake up is Christmas.
Yeah?
Every day you wake up, it's like, it's a gift. It's like another day. You get to be here. You get to experience all the bullshit. You get to experience all the good shit. Yeah. I mean, it's everything. You know what I mean? It's every day is Christmas, really.
Yeah, and what's dope about, you know, this whole half Christmas thing or Christmas in July is that when it's not during Christmas, we're not caught in that hustle and bustle that we were talking about of getting the decorations, of buying the new Christmas present, getting the Turbo Man doll. You know, that's not,
Turbo Man.
That's not part of it. It's all just about, you know, coming together, chilling, being a family, being a, you know, having the camaraderie and that Christmas spirit that you have during Christmas where you become a better person. And you're like, oh, it's Christmas time, so I'm going to, you know, give this bum a fucking five spot, or I'm going to help out my fucking cousin who needs help moving or something. Like, you know, I'll do this because it's Christmas time and I'm more inclined to be a better person. Well, you can do that all year. You know what I mean? And you could do that today on half Christmas and just have that same feeling. Try to be that person that you are during the holidays, because everybody is, you know, like Jerry Seinfeld was saying earlier, it's, you're not the mistakes you've made. Like, you're the person you are today, and you've learned from all these things that you've done in your life. So, you know, today you can be how you are at your best. You know, it's up to you to, you know, how you're going to interact with the world, what kind of person you're going to be, how you're going to go out into life and tackle your life. And, you know, if you take more control of your life, then the outcome's always going to be better. And that's what Half Christmas is all about to me, is trying to be that best person that I could be.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm trying to do. Spread the love. And I actually have, since I was talking about taking the retail out of the equation, there's some statistics here about holiday retail sales in the U.S. are at $630 billion in total, with retail, cost of employment, e-commerce, all of these different stores. It's $3.19 trillion just within the Christmas season.
That's so what's
up. A lot of money is exchanged, a lot of products sold and bought, a lot of advertisement.
And think about this, right? Like, the more that this thing becomes a trend of paying people more, you know, the more that a better wage becomes a trend, the more money there's going to be for everybody. You know what I mean? It's like, the more people make, the fucking more people spend, you know what I mean? And when more people spend in their local economy, it fucking does well for everything, you know? Like, everything boosts, everything becomes better, everyone becomes better, everybody benefits, you know? It's like, it's crazy to think otherwise. It's crazy to think that people still make $8 an hour in some places. Or,
right. That's, you know, fucked up.
It's crazy that motherfuckers are fighting to, like, keep it less than $15 an hour. And, I don't know, man. It's greedy, and half Christmas isn't.
Yeah, you know? I agree. And, you know, it's fucked up. There has been more, like, people have been more conscious about it, about the cost of living in certain areas and how minimum wage and, you know, the cost of living and minimum rent for, like, a one-bedroom apartment, it, like, doesn't match up. And just one person working their job, like, I saw, I'm not used to it because I make tips and I run one of the most successful podcasts in the world. But, you know, like, I have tips every day that gets me through, that gets me gas money and, you know, fucking weed and all these things that I need. And I saw someone post something the other day and said that they got their paycheck, you know, made like so much money. They make a couple dollars over minimum wage. They paid their bills and their rent and all their shit, and they have $25 left for the rest of the week. And he was like, I haven't even gotten gas or bought groceries yet. So this is my $25 that's going to last me. And it's like, that's not enough. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's crazy.
And, you know, there's people that are just scraping by, and people that are abusing the system that we have in place to help people. So, you know, nobody knows who really needs help or not. And there's a lot of people.
Hopefully the curve stays the way it's going, and, you know, and we stay on this upward spiral. We're trying to win right now. So
yeah,
I don't know. It seems like it's going well. You know what I mean?
Was that a good spot for that?
Yeah, we're doing good. The struggle continues, right? That's the thing.
Uh huh. Mhm.
That's a great way to end this.
The struggle continues. Yeah. So I'm gonna go out there and make myself some eggnog on this half Christmas day of love. But we actually have a clip right here that goes along the lines of what we're talking about.
We are going to fight hard. Thank you all. The struggle continues.
Thank you all. The top 1% of the top 10% of the country will come together. And we will be strong. And the 10% of the top 1% of the 1% will see that we are a force to be reckoned with.
You almost had it.
Almost. Yeah. It was pretty close.
It was pretty close.
I threw a lot of 1% and 10% in there.
Yeah.
That kind of covers a lot of what he's talking about.
You threw him in there backwards, though.
You threw him in there backwards, though.
Yeah, but you almost had it.
The top 10% of the 1% of the top 1%. Mm-hmm. So yeah. Happy half Christmas or merry half Christmas? I like happy half Christmas. Say them both out loud.
Then christen it.
Happy half Christmas, everybody. There it is. That's a christening, right? Or do I have to break a bottle?
Yeah, that's it. Well, yeah, break the bottle. You got it?
Yeah, I got it. I didn't have a bottle.
Natural Habitat recording.